table with our checkbook and our wallets out. We have a greater obligation and responsibility, not in fact to in any way dictate, not in any way to demand, but indeed to reflect the values and principles and the aspirations that we know are a part of the fundamental basis of a strong civil society. I don't agree for one moment that a person, because they might have a PhD or a high-level degree, is more aware or understanding of the needs of what a peasant farmer who is illiterate needs and wants to make. Here in this country, an Iowa farmer is just as important as a New York City politician. And I think, quite honestly, a peasant farmer who's growing matoki in Imbarara, who is illiterate, has as much right to be able to influence the outcome of events as members of Parliament. But we also must make sure that the institutions don't suppress the views of the people while trying to say they represent
them. I'll be very brief because what Johnny just said about the importance of institutions over individuals and homegrown solutions from the bottom up is clearly the only way to an enduring construction of such institutions. But let me turn briefly to Callisto Madalo's remarks, because I think his comments were also spot on. This is a process, again, that has to be internally driven, and they asked the question, what type of assistance do outsiders provide? Well, I think one problem, frankly, is that my experience of the last 10 years, there is a division of labor that's opened up that's also created a gap between the bilateral institutions and the multilateral institutions. The bilateral institutions wading into the political thicket, sometimes a bit aggressively so, support for elections, support for parliaments, support for the rule of law, I think increasingly nuanced, by the way, in recent years, particularly as there has been a shift to strengthening parliaments, such as actually an ExoDSID project in Kenya and a joint one between USAID and DFID down in Dar es Salaam. But the multilaterals, on the other hand, while they have talked a tremendous amount about governance, and I've been involved with one, that governance is defined as being devoid of politics, and that's kind of an oxymoron. Governance involves, indeed involves, strengthening public sector reforms, supply-side type reforms, but also involves demand-side reforms, and it also involves, perhaps most fundamentally, if given its bylaws, institutions like the bank cannot wade into the political thicket, at least in an analytical level, its staff must have an understanding of the political process. And here, I think, the bank in particular, it is still contested terrain. The jury is out. But that would be my response to your question. And I might just finally, budget support, which there's a great logic behind it, again, in terms of ownership. I think what the Uganda case suggests is that budget support, like other silver bullets of the A game in the past, may not. It's a much more complex situation than that. And it gets down to this very balance of the question you raise of how you assist development efforts that are defined locally and yet are going to fly and have a political legitimacy to them, and indeed consolidate and not lose the achievements that Uganda achieved. So, thank you very much for your
wisdom. Let me, in closing, just make a couple of very quick observations. First of all, I hope that I want to pick up on something that a couple of the interventions from the audience have noted, which which is that Uganda's history is one of the more remarkable success stories in the African continent, and therefore why should it be now kind of a subject of discussion and of criticism? I hope that it is understood that the spirit of this undertaking today is precisely because we want the success story to remain a success story and not to decline. Johnny, I think, said very eloquently that one of the key elements of a sustainable democracy in any society is the quality of institutions. A society that is dependent upon the force of a single personality, it will not be durable, almost by definition. It only lasts as long as that personality is there. But there's other aspects of democracy. One of them is it's constantly a work in progress, and that's true of all democracies. I venture to suggest that the recent years has demonstrated pretty dramatically, I think, that the American democracy itself has some significant occasional challenges with respect to rule of law and some of the principles that we like to espouse elsewhere. We didn't always apply some of those principles as faithfully in our own conduct of our own democracy. In the final analysis, the greatest strength, I would argue, of any democracy, in fact, I would argue the strongest test of democracy, is the ability to be self-critical. If, in fact, the raising of issues becomes simply a cause for drawing the wagons in a circle and defending against all suggestions that maybe things are not quite perfect, if that becomes the response, it's a terribly lost opportunity. My hope is that the kind of debate and discussion we've had today, which, as I say, I hope that was the beginning and certainly not an end of the process, can encourage all Ugandans inside the government, outside the government, and to encourage all of us who are concerned with issues of democratization, issues of transformation economically of societies that are facing such challenges, to take a good hard look. Not in order to throw blame, but in order to identify a better way forward. I want to express again my appreciation to all the folks who are up on this panel, to Steve Morrison and to CSIS for joining in co-sponsorship of this event. Delighted to have the minister here. I know that Mr. Moses also wanted to make an intervention. I hope you'll respect the reasons why we couldn't have provided that kind of time. But again, I repeat that there will be other platforms available for the Ugandan government. If there's any response is desired in terms of this material, we'd be glad to post that on the website as well. To all of you, thank you for being here and for participating.